paix et quelqu'un pour tuer la guerre. Nous serons comme des enfants quand on s'amuse en bas, dans les prés.
The new film is not limited by the requirements of existing formats. It is said that the production is costly, the technical means are expensive, the air times, copyrights, financing possibilities and constraints, production assistants, catering trucks, teams and managers, the equipment and its insurance, the entertainment and cultural industries, the institutions with their processes and press departments, application procedures and legal templates, are the obstacles for a new film. The new film defies the odds of these requirements. Against the insistence on the necessities, the new film sets on possibilities. The material has already been produced, the technical means are everywhere at hand. Who is authorized to make history and who is not should not be understood as something pre-established.
Changed my life.
The new film treats the subject and the actor as equals. There are no triggers and no aesthetic codes, no narrative or modulation, which dictate how to make sense of the things that are shown. The filmic image is understood as an aesthetic surface. The sequences do not progress in a predictable fashion. What can be seen in conventional image media today is usually driven by a fear to displease and worries about comprehensibility. The new film turns against the posture of understanding that is common in documentary filmmaking, and the alleged clarity of the explanatory voice. In lieu of that clarity, the new film proposes a precise ambiguity.
The new film ignores the profit-driven priorities given to storytelling. The reality of the new film does not pretend to be in sync with the present. It is constructed through narratives of likely events. The new film uses the material of the present and insists on the necessity to fictionalize meaningful acts. In doing so, the dividing line between the factual and the symbolic gets blurred. The screen appears as a symbolic reality and celebrates the collapse of the current with the virtual.
The narration of the new film is not based on plots and storytelling, but operates more like a search algorithm that creates connections between images based on affinities rather than ostensible meaning. Gilles Deleuze's concept of fabulation points at this relation of aesthetic uncertainty. As the signs become more heterogeneous and visual and auditory signals drift apart, art becomes more and more political. Thus, meaning is understood as less individual but individual or polyphonic. The new film contains no synchronized, natural sounds that follow the image. Sound no longer supports the politics of the image, but rather serves as a commentary.
The appearance of equality is an effect of the reality of the screen, which the new film tries to undermine. Now, the virtual serves to open a utopian horizon within the image. The deliberate impoverishment of expression and stuttering of the codes are the means of the new film. Recursive elements, compression, fragmentation, deceleration and deliberate omissions confuse the timelines and hierarchies of storytelling and thereby recover the correlations that are obfuscated by habitual modes of display.
The camera of the new film is indifferent. It opposes the trademark aesthetics and their recognition value. The new film does not follow any logic of representation. Everyone is potentially in it, including the ones that are not mentioned, the invisible, the otherwise underrepresented.